failure of Operation Barbarossa to decisively defeat the Soviet Union by the end of 1941 forced Germans to change their strategy. Hitler decided that Germany's summer campaign in 1942 would be directed at the Caucasus and the Stalingrad. Additionally, the Germans were supported by armies of their allies, Romanians, Italians, and Hungarians. Stalin was expecting the main thrust of the German summer attacks to be directed against Moscow again, so Red Army had been surprised second time. The attack was preceded by intense Luftwaffe bombing that reduced much of the city to rubble. On the 23rd of August, the 6th Army reached the outskirts of Stalingrad. By mid-November, the Germans at great cost had pushed the Soviet defenders back into narrow zones along the west bank of the Volga River. The Soviets realized their critical situation, ordering everyone who could hold a rifle into the fight. German army stalled in the face of Soviet reinforcements, but bloody battle continued. Georgi Zhukov asked Stalin to concentrate forces in order to prepare encirclement operation. Stalin gave him permission. And on the 19th of November the Red Army launched Operation Uranus, a two-pronged attack targeting the Axis armies protecting the 6th Army's flanks. The Axis flanks were overrun and the 6th Army was cut off and surrounded in the Stalingrad area. Adolf Hitler was determined to hold the city at all costs and forbade the 6th Army from attempting a breakout. So Paulus and his men had to stay in Stalingrad. Manstein's troops couldn't help encircled army. On the 2nd of February 1943, the German 6th Army, under Friedrich Paulus, having exhausted their ammunition and food, finally capitulated after over 5 months of fighting. the destruction of an entire army and the frustration of Germany's grand strategy made the battle a watershed moment of the war.